Fantastic. I finally caught my very first queen ant. I can't wait to raise my personal ant empire all by myself. I'm so excited. Wait. And now? What should I do? Do I need to move the queen to a new nest? Should I feed her? And what should I give her? If you're sitting there thinking that this situation mirrors exactly what you're going through right now, then you can breathe a sigh of relief, because you just found the perfect answer to all of your questions. This is the right video for you. Let's see which actions you should consider taking now that you've just encountered your very first queen ant. Hi guys. Hope you're doing well. Welcome back to the BRUMA Ants channel. As you saw in the intro of the video, in this guide you're going to learn what are the right steps to take to properly kick off an ant colony, starting from the most important member of them all, a newly mated queen ant. Catching your very first queen ant can be an amazing and fulfilling experience for an ant keeper, especially if you are new to this fantastic hobby. Watching the queen care for the next generation of workers is an extremely relaxing and enjoyable pastime, and makes you really appreciate how cool and smart these tiny animals can be. The founding stage is probably the most important and critical moment in the life of an ant colony, and knowing what to do now is crucial for ensuring the health and success of your future little ant empire. In this video, we'll explore everything you need to know about this important founding stage. Where to put her, what to feed her, and everything you need to know to lay the foundation for a healthy and prosperous ant colony. This is just the beginning of an amazing ant-keeping journey, and understanding these basic steps is essential to become a successful ant-keeper. So, what should you do after catching your very first queen ant? Let's start with the first step. Where should I put her? Okay, you just caught your first queen ant, and now she's probably sitting inside some sort of small plastic container like this one. These types of containers are not very good for housing a small ant colony in its founding stage, and in some cases, they can actually create more harm than good. The main reason why these containers are not the best type of nests when it comes to starting an ant colony, is due to their inability to provide a stable and suitable environment for the ants. Ants, especially in the early stages of colony development, require specific conditions to thrive. These conditions include a constant humidity level and a stable temperature, which are almost impossible to maintain in a small plastic container like this one. Furthermore, the complete absence of a proper and always available water source can lead to dehydration, compromising the queen and her future brood. These kinds of containers are also very difficult to maintain, as the living space for the colony is extremely limited. For these important reasons, we need to create a better founding nest alternative, one which has a water source, some moisture, and it's easy to maintain. In this situation, the so-called test tube setup comes to our rescue. This particular type of setup is considered by most ant keepers to be the gold standard of founding nests. The test tube setup is undoubtedly the best way to recreate the environment that a young colony experiences in the wild, as it accurately replicates the same amount of space, humidity, and temperature. The brilliance of the test tube setup lies in its simplicity and effectiveness in mimicking the natural habitat that ants experience in the wild. It provides a controlled environment where humidity and temperature can be easily maintained, ensuring the best possible start for the queen and her young offspring. The water reservoir at the end of the tube, separated by a little piece of cotton, offers a consistent water source, addressing the critical need for hydration and humidity. To build this effective type of founding nest, you don't need lots of items. The most important element of a test tube setup is, as the name suggests, a test tube. For this setup, the material of the test tube doesn't matter very much, and you can choose between glass and plastic as you please. Apart from the test tube, you're gonna also need some cotton, water, and, if you want, some sort of plastic pipette, like the one I'm showing you right now. The assembly of the test tube setup is pretty straightforward, but it's also extremely important to get it right. The cotton must be placed correctly to prevent the water from flooding the living space where the queen lives, while still allowing moisture to permeate the environment. This perfect balance ensures that the queen remains comfortable, safe, and ready to start her colony under the best possible conditions. If you're watching this video, there's probably a very high chance that you are just starting out with this hobby, and that you don't have any idea on how to make this kind of nest setup. But you don't need to worry about that. I made a detailed step-by-step guide on how to make the perfect test tube setup. In the video, I explain in detail everything you need to know to successfully prepare a test tube setup, starting from the basic aspects of this popular founding nest, all the way to the final result. Now that we have our test tube set up, it's time to give our queen a new home. To move your precious queen into her new nest, just remove the cotton ball to open the setup, and gently encourage her to find the path to the test tube. Try to make this as safe as possible, as we definitely don't want to harm the queen in the process. Ensuring the safety of the queen during this extremely important transition phase is a crucial step for the future of the colony. This is a critical moment, and a not-so-smooth transition can significantly affect her well-being and her subsequent ability to produce healthy and strong worker ants. When the queen is in, close the test tube with the cotton ball. Fantastic! Now our queen has a proper home, in which she can start laying her first batch of eggs and raise her own little ant empire. As your queen settles into her new home, it's important to place the test tube in a quiet, dark place, in order to mimic the same natural conditions she would have experienced if she were out in the wild. This wild-like habitat encourages her to lay eggs in a stress-free environment, creating the foundation for a prosperous and healthy ant colony. During this important founding period, it is essential to constantly monitor the queen and her future brood, ensuring she has everything she needs to thrive and that she is adapting well to her new home. However, it's crucial not to disturb the queen too much during this phase. To minimize stress, I suggest checking on her only about once a week, which is the perfect trade-off to balance care with reducing disturbance. In the next step, we're going to answer another frequently asked question regarding this important founding stage. Let's continue. Should I feed the queen? To answer this important question, we first need to understand the difference between fully claustral and semi-claustral queens. A fully claustral ant is a type of queen ant that is able to start a new colony without needing to forage for food. That's because this particular type of queen can use the nutrients she already has in her body to feed herself and her first few generations of offspring. This useful characteristic allows the queen to establish a new colony in a location where food is not readily available, increasing the chance of surviving the founding period. This is the perfect example of the resilience and self-sufficiency of these insects, allowing them to thrive in environments where food sources are scarce or competition is high. On the other hand, a semi-claustral queen is a type of queen ant that doesn't have this ability and needs to forage for food even during her founding stage. This requires venturing outside the nest, which can expose the vulnerable queen to predators and other dangers. However, this also means that semi-claustral queens are forced to start their colonies in areas where immediate foraging is feasible and very easy, making it easier to feed the future members of the colony. Now that we know the differences between these two types of founding options, we need to check whether our queen is fully claustral or not. To do that, we have to find out which species of ant our queen belongs to. This identification step is extremely important, as it directly influences the care and strategy we need to choose in order to successfully raise our ant colony. If you don't know it yet, you can ask a question in one of the many online forums dedicated to ant keeping, sending them some pictures of your newly caught queen. When you have the name of the species, check online whether she's a fully claustral species or not. As a general rule, you can check the gaster of the queen. If it's large and voluminous compared to the rest of her body, she's likely fully claustral. On the other hand, if the gaster is small and thin, she's probably semi-claustral, and needs to be fed during the founding stage. This visual inspection can be a very quick and effective way to broadly understand the type of care your queen will require. However, even if the queen you just caught is fully claustral, I would suggest you give them a little drop of honey. This little sugar boost will help the queen stay energized during the long founding period, and will also help her first workers during their first days. Providing this little supplemental feeding can be the key to a successful colony startup, ensuring that the queen and her initial brood have the best possible chance at survival. Now we can put the test tube set up and our little queen ant in a safe and quiet place, giving her the time to lay her first batch of eggs and start her own ant colony. This step officially marks the beginning of an incredible journey into the amazing world of ant keeping, offering a window into the complex and highly organized world of ants. Starting an ant colony from a single queen can be a fun and educational experience, and can provide a unique and fascinating glimpse into the world of these fascinating creatures. By understanding the needs of your queen and providing for them accordingly, you can witness the birth and growth of a new ant colony right before your eyes. This hobby not only brings the wonder of nature into your home, but also teaches you valuable lessons about biology, ecology, and the importance of caring for our smaller Earth inhabitants. If you're new to ant keeping and want to be sure to start this hobby the best possible way, I would strongly suggest you check out this other video. This is a complete and detailed starting guide to ant keeping, explaining everything you need to know to move your first steps in this amazing and underrated hobby. See you soon in another video.